In this video, I'm going to show you how to unlock the true power of LoRAs within ComfyUI and take your image generation to the next level. We will cover everything from installing LoRAs, setting up workflows, and much more. Plus, I will share tips on combining multiple LoRAs, fixing common issues, and creating ultra-realistic images. Stick around till the end, you won't want to miss the exciting possibilities I will showcase. Let's get started. LoRA, short for Low Rank Adaptation, is a technique used to create specialized models that build on top of a pre-trained base model. The key benefit of LoRA is that it allows you to fine-tune a model without having to retrain the entire thing. Instead, only a small number of parameters are adjusted, which significantly reduces the memory and computational power required for training. This means you can train a model with much less processing power, which is really amazing. To make this clearer, let us look at an example. Imagine you have lots of photos of a specific car, like a BMW, and you want to train a model to generate images of this exact car. Normally, the base model might not be able to generate this specific BMW because it was not trained on those images, but with LoRA, you can fine-tune the model using these BMW photos without changing the entire model, and afterward, you would be able to use LoRA and the base model to generate the specific image on which you trained it. So essentially, LoRA allows you to bring specific objects, styles, characters, poses, and much more into your generated images. This gives you much more control over the output, which is really cool. Now let us move on to the installation. Once you have clicked on the LoRA download link in the description, you will be taken to this document. Here, you will find the installation guide with all the necessary links. The first thing you will see is my Patreon page, where you can become a member to support me. As a bonus, you will also get today's workflows and much more, which will make the installation process significantly easier. In addition to the LoRA workflows, there are also upscalers, face fix tools, and many other useful workflows. Another note, you will find a link to my Discord server here as well. There, you can ask questions if you encounter any issues or exchange ideas with others. But now, back to the installation. First, you need to download the RG3 nodes. Click on the provided link to download the zip file. Extract the zip file to the ComfyUI folder under custom nodes. Keep in mind that your file path might differ from mine, as I am using Pinocchio. Once you have extracted the files, you can return to the document. Next, we are going to download the LoRAs. Click the link that will take you to Civit AI. There, you can filter LoRAs based on your needs. For example, if you are looking for SDXL LoRAs, you can set that in the filters. In my case, I am using model 1.5. I am now going to select a LoRA that creates a specific futuristic cyberpunk style look for apartments. I will save it in the ComfyUI folder under models and then under LoRAs. Before I do that, I will create a new folder to better organize the Flux and SDXL models. I recommend you do the same. Next, we will install the Flux LoRAs. I am selecting Flux Dev because I use this version for Flux, and then I will go to the Cars category and, for example, install this Porsche LoRA. Remember, for some LoRAs or models on Civit AI, you will need to log in. I will do that now. Once you have downloaded the LoRA, save it in the same path as before and create a separate folder for the Flux Dev LoRAs as well. Finally, I will download a few more cool LoRAs for a later demonstration, which we will try out and even mix together. With the latest update, a practical new ComfyUI design has been added. To activate it, go to the settings and choose whether you want the interface at the top or bottom. I am opting for the top position. As you can see, the new intuitive design is now active. Here, you can view the images you have recently generated, and you have access to both the nodes library and the models library. Additionally, there is a folder where you can save and organize your workflows. These features allow you to manage many aspects of ComfyUI and boost your productivity. There is also a dark mode and light mode, as well as your settings easily available at the bottom. At the top, you will find some useful functions, and the manager is now accessible here. If you do not have this manager yet, you can download it from my first ComfyUI video. It is particularly handy for managing nodes, missing nodes, and other features. At the top, you can also perform actions on your models, such as unloading a model. There are also additional settings for custom nodes, and you can open your console from here as well. At the bottom of the interface, you have the section where you can generate images and perform other actions. You can position this block wherever you like. On the far right, you will find zoom options and a few other cool features. The new design is quite self-explanatory. However, if you would like a detailed explanation of the individual features, feel free to check out my first ComfyUI video where I explain everything in detail. Now let us move on to the workflows. If you are a supporter, you can easily download my supporter workflow and use the LoRA workflows directly by simply dragging the JSON file into ComfyUI. For everyone else, I will show you the basic setup of the workflows. It is really simple. Even if you are a supporter, I recommend watching along, as I will be sharing many useful tips that could be helpful to you. If you have seen my recent videos, you already know how to set up workflows for Flux and SDXL. Once you have built the basic structure, you just need to add and connect one more node, the power loader node. This node connects to the clip, the model, and then to the case sampler, as well as the two prompt nodes. I will now tidy things up a bit, and then we will move on to the workflow for Flux LoRAs. We will create the same node here as well. I will quickly adjust the color of the group to make them easier to distinguish. Then I will connect the node to the model and the other nodes. Just follow along with what I am doing. Next, we will need the clip, which we will connect to the prompt node. Once that is done, I will quickly organize everything again. I just want to quickly mention, if anything is unclear, make sure to check out my ComfyUI videos to help you follow along and better understand everything. Now let us dive into how to properly use LoRAs. First, we will start with SDXL LoRAs. Select the appropriate model and configure the recommended settings, which you can find on the model page, or feel free to experiment a bit. In the newly created node, you can now add one of the downloaded LoRAs. Do not forget to refresh ComfyUI so the LoRA appears, especially if you had ComfyUI open during the download. Next, let me show you why we created the folders. Go to the RG3 settings, check this box, and set the value to 2 or 5, for example. As you can see, our folders are now organized, and everything is neatly in place. Once we have selected our SDXL model, we can right-click and retrieve the information, such as the trigger word we need to include in our prompt to ensure the LoRA influences the generated image. You can also pull info from Civit AI, which is very useful. This can provide you with additional trigger words and sample images to help you use the LoRA more effectively. I will now add the trigger words to my prompt node. Also, if you have organized your nodes into groups, do not forget to use the bypass function to disable any nodes you are not using. This is very handy, as you can easily bypass the LoRA node if you do not want to generate with it. Let us generate an image now. I will skip the generation process for the sake of time. As you can see, the LoRA has applied the desired style to the image. Now, let us move on to something even more exciting. I will demonstrate this with Flux LoRAs. We will bypass the SDXL workflow and unbypass the Flux LoRA workflow. The concept remains the same here. Select the LoRA model, in this case the BMW LoRA, retrieve the information, and integrate the trigger word into your prompt. I will now generate an example image and change the license plate to Aris. After skipping the generation process, you can see the 10 results, and the outcomes are truly impressive. However, there may still be some error pictures as well. If you have enjoyed the video so far, do not forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more content like this. Next, I will switch over to my supporter workflow and showcase a few LoRAs there. At the top, you'll find the SDXL LoRA workflow. There is also an upscaler and face fix, which I'll demonstrate later. Further down, you will see the Flux LoRA workflow. The other workflows are from previous videos, including an in-painting workflow, a Flux control net workflow, and a few others. All the workflows from my videos so far are available here. Now let us focus on the Flux LoRA workflow. As you can see, I have already generated a Porsche with the LoRA, but I will go ahead now and create an image of the Porsche from the back and give you a few more tips. Here is the Porsche from behind with my channel name on it. You may notice that Porsche is misspelled on the car, so what can you do to fix that? First, you can add the word directly to the prompt to ensure it is considered. After the second generation, it is improved, but still not perfect. Another option is to change the image size. If you watched my last video, you know about the size chart, which lists different image sizes you can use. But why should we do this? Not only does it improve the image quality, but the LoRA may have been trained on a different size than 512, which could be why the result is not as expected. Always check the creator's recommendations to find the optimal size for the model. As you can see, the result is now much better. Let us save the image, insert it below, and upscale it. The final result is really impressive. Now let me show you an example with a character by using a LoRA to generate Lara Croft. I will take the trigger words, add them to my prompt, and voila, we have a great image. You can really see the possibilities LoRAs offer here. In my upcoming videos, I will show you how to train your own LoRAs and even create your own character. Stay tuned. This opens up even more cool opportunities. For characters, I often use face fix to make the face flawless. You can skip this, but if you encounter issues with the face, it can be very helpful. After that, I upscale the image, and the result is fantastic. In the workflow, you should always use the bypass function to disable unnecessary nodes. If any nodes are missing during generation, you can reactivate them. Here is an example with the ultra-realistic LoRA. As you can see from the examples, this LoRA is extremely helpful and has generated many great images. It looks incredibly realistic. Now, I want to show you how to combine two LoRAs. I will take the pink nylon tights gloves suit LoRA and combine it with the ultra-realistic LoRA. I will select both LoRAs and briefly touch on the strength setting. As you can see, I have set the strength to 1 by default, but you can experiment with it. Strength controls how much influence a LoRA has on the image. If you are using two LoRAs and one is not having enough influence, you can increase its strength and lower the strength of the other. Play around with the values and observe how they affect your image. Sometimes, a strength of 1 can be too much, so always check the LoRA creator's recommendations. Once I have selected both LoRAs, I will add the trigger words to my prompt and organize it. As you can see, both LoRAs were successfully applied. I could now reduce the strength of the pink nylon suit LoRA to 0.7 so that the ultra realistic LoRA has more influence on the image, but it looks good as is. You also have the option of combining 3 or even 4 LoRAs and many more, but the more you have, the worse the image quality can be. I recommend a maximum of 3 LoRAs. Now let us move on to another example with the BMW LoRA and the model kit LoRA. I have set the model kit LoRA to 0.7 to ensure the BMW is fully generated without errors. After adjusting all the trigger words and the prompt, I get a fantastic result as you can see. You can generate truly amazing things with LoRAs and get really creative. It is important to experiment on your own as there are no limits here. Stay tuned for my video on training your own LoRAs. And with that, I am wrapping up the video. I hope you enjoyed it. Feel free to check out my last video if you want to learn more about Control Net Flux, or better yet, watch the entire ComfyUI playlist to make sure you fully understand how everything works. Thank you for watching and see you next time.